Majority of farmers in eastern Uganda engage in rice cultivation, considering it their primary cash crop and a crucial source of livelihood. However, their harvests suffer significantly due to inadequate post-harvest practices, resulting in diminished returns on their investment. In a bid to address the issue at hand, the Grain Council of Uganda, the Ministry of Agriculture, and the African Fertilizer Agribusiness Partnership have initiated campaigns to raise awareness about enhancing post-harvest methods. The aim is to improve the quality of rice and align it with the market prices, ensuring a more sustainable and profitable outcome for rice farmers in the region.
And where I am now here, this farmer has a problem. His rice is already colored, is already dirty because of the problem of he failed to control water in his garden. Failed to control water and with the garden flooded at the time of harvesting. So there is a lot of mud. There was a lot of mud. This rice was wetted. And now she's drying rice, but with a lot of mud on it. That's why its color is like this.
The aim of educating farmers on effective post-harvest methods is not only to enhance the quality of agricultural products in the market, but also to minimize the losses currently faced by farmers.
Much as the farmers may be planting the right seed, at the end of the day they lose a lot in terms of post-harvest losses. Right now the estimates are between 20 to 30%. Farmers are losing a lot of their produce in post-harvest management practices. And that is why we decided to carry out a countrywide training in post-harvest handling. And over 10,000 farmers have been trained specifically on post-harvest handling.
We are interested in this as the Grain Council because we want our members to trade in grain that is good quality, that will bring them good money, and not only good money, but it will also it should also be safe. The kind of grain that they deal in should be safe food for all those who consume it.
This endeavor is part of the Sustain Africa initiative, which originated in response to the urgent challenges posed by the COVID-19 pandemic. Since its inception, the initiative has successfully distributed 30,000 metric tons of fertilizers to farmers at subsidized rates.
It was an initiative, an emergency response to the COVID effects that started last year. The fertilizer prices went up. That means there were constraints around availing inputs and even affordability of inputs for the smallholder farmers. So one of the things we did was to reduce the prices of fertilizers. We actually subsidized the cost of fertilizers to ensure that farmers are able to access and produce more food.
Uganda annually yields 350,000 metric tons of rice, with eastern Uganda being the leading contributor. Effective post-harvest management, storage, and adoption of innovative technologies have the potential to minimize losses, enhance food quality and safety, and boost both food security and income for smallholder farms. Report compiled by Jimmy Luima for the news.